Can I take a poll? How many people knew John Cage's name before coming to this concert? Oh, good. Okay. And how many people had heard John Cage's music? Okay, cool.
I find that a lot of the time,
Cage's aesthetic seems to overpower some of his music. Maybe people haven't heard it. There's different things happening. A few years ago, Madeline did a similar concert. Sort of celebrated not only Cage but Merce Cunningham, his longtime partner and dancer. And if memory serves, I did Child of Tree, which is a solo percussion piece for amplified cactuses. I thought this time I'd play a solo piece and maybe talk a little bit about how Cage's sound world sort of affected me. I'm a percussionist by trade, composer, and also dealing with electronics in different ways. Early on, Cage a little bit after he studied with Arnold Schoenberg. Paying attention to this. This is for later. I think it all works. Started writing pieces for a percussion ensemble, a little bit different than the usual snare drums and bass drums and things like that. He started using break drums and coffee cans, and I've sort of incorporated some of that tonight. And over the years, I've done a lot of solo work, and often this involves some more traditional drums, but then some found on objects and also some amplified stuff. You can see here, this is a off a tractor. My father's a sewer contractor. I don't know if he knows I took it and put a mic on it, but I don't know if it matters. One of the other things I found really interesting about Cage was in the mid-50s, he was writing pieces for magnetic tape, and he got kind of a little bit fed up with it, and he started dealing with live electronics, especially in his work with David Tudor, the great pianist. And they were actually building circuits, building little things and, you know, butter tubs and things like that. Creating, you know, today it's very odd. A lot of people are circuit bending electronics and doing different things, but this was sort of a beginning of a lot of things. This setup right here is actually a bunch of guitar effects pedals plugged into themselves. There's no guitar or electric bass or anything. So what we're dealing with here is feedback loops. The chain goes this way, I think. And comes out here, there's a few effects processors after the fact. There's also this other thing over here, but I don't want to ruin the surprise. We're going to start really simple. This is an AM radio transmitter. My BlackBerry.